Structure of striated muscle fiber. Muscle fibers, they are tiny myofibrils. So here I have drawn few stripes white in color. Say for example, these are spaghetti. And when we will zoom into the structure, what we will see, that we will see alternate light and dark colored bands. We will see alternate light and dark colored bands. Now these light and dark colored bands are due to the arrangement of actin and myosin in the sarcomere. Okay, now let's see the structure. So here we can see that there are thick filaments and thin filaments, and there is a overlapping between the thick filament and thin filament. Okay, the thick filament represent here the myosin and the thin filament represent the actin. There is a region in the sarcomere where the thick filament and thin filament overlaps. So this region, wherever there is the overlapping, this region is dark. Okay, here is also the overlapping, so this region is dark. So wherever there is no overlapping, that is light. Okay, so these are light bands where there is no overlapping, and these are dark bands where there is overlapping between the actin and myosin. So the light bands, there will be no overlapping between actin and myosin. So it will look somewhat like this. Whenever there is the overlapping, okay, this is the dark band, and wherever there is no overlapping, that will be the light band. So this is dark band, and the one where there is no overlapping is the light band, that is here, here and here. Okay, so if we look into the structure of a muscle, we see that each muscle is made up of several fascicles. Okay, each muscle is made up of several fascicles, which you can see here. Each muscle is made up of several fascicles. Each fascicle is made up of several muscle fibers. Okay, each muscle fiber is made up of myofibril. And we already discussed the structure of a myofibril, which is made up of thick filament and thin filament. Thick filament, which is myosin, and thin filament, which is actin. In this structure, you can see that each muscle fiber is covered by epimysium. Okay, each muscle is covered by and these muscles are made up of fascicles. Okay, these fascicles, each fascicle is covered by perimysium, the structure which you can see here. I'll change the color. This structure is perimysium. Okay, so each fascicles, they are covered by perimysium. Okay, so I said that the whole of the fascicles are covered by perimysium, and the bundle of muscle fiber is covered by endomysium. The bundle of muscle fiber is covered by endomysium. So is the three term, I think it's clear to all of you. Now these muscle fiber, which are made up of myofibrils, this muscle fiber also contains sarcoplasmic reticulum. This sarcoplasmic reticulum is represented here by network. Okay, also these muscle fiber contains large number of nucleus and mitochondria. Clear? So what we discussed in this lecture, that myofibrils will form what? Muscle fibers. These muscle fibers include myofibrils, also include sarcoplasmic reticulum, which forms the network, They also contains peripheral nucleus as well as mitochondria. These muscle fibers will form, the bundle of muscle fibers will form fascicle, and the fascicle together will form the muscle. Okay, and also we discussed the different covering, that the muscle is covered by the epimysium and the bundle of fascicle. Okay, the whole bundle of fascicle is covered by perimysium, and a single bundle of muscle fiber is covered by endomysium. The white colored covering which you can see, it is endomysium, and the whole covering outside the bundle of fascicle is the perimysium. Also look at this picture, that the covering of the muscle fiber is known as sarcolemma, which is the covering of muscle fiber. I hope this has helped you. Thank you.